Cindy's Table. I'm Cindy. We have a great show planned for you today. I have my friend Lindsay Gomes with me. She is a dietitian for ShopRite in both Manchester and East Hartford store. Hey, Lindsay.
Hey, how are you?
Good. So happy that you're here today.
So excited.
And we have some great recipes, and they're all make ahead recipes that are healthy for us and for our family, for
exactly.
our kids, working parents, or even just on the go.
Yeah.
You know, food that we can take with us. So we have some great recipes for you. And you can find all these recipes on my blog at cindystable.com. And everything we got today is at ShopRite. So Lindsay did a lot of our shopping for us. Thanks,
yes.
Lindsay.
You're welcome.
So I love my egg muffins. And the reason why I make them is they're great for leftovers.
Yes.
So whatever I had the night before, I could make, you know, using the protein, or I can make vegetable. I even love making pizza flavored ones with pepperoni and cheese, so the kids will eat it. And I think if you get your kids involved, they might even want to eat breakfast. So I'm gonna use some leftover pork sausage that I had from the night before. Mm-hmm. Doesn't that look great? It's already cut up. And I'm gonna add some peppers and onions, some cheese. Nice and simple, but these are going to be great. And what I love about these, Lindsay, is we can freeze them.
Yes.
30 seconds in the microwave and you can freeze them. So I'm gonna let you talk about some of the nutrition value of eating these egg muffins in the morning while I get the stove going.
Sure. Yeah, so these egg muffins are great for not only breakfast, you can even use it as an appetizer for a party. But what's good is you start off with the eggs, you can't lose. You know, it's a great source of protein and it's inexpensive. So starting off the eggs is a good start.
Exactly.
And then you can really add, like Cindy said, any kind of leftovers you have. So what I like to do sometimes is if I have leftover stir fry, I'll actually use those vegetables and add it into my eggs. It's a good way to get those vegetables into your meal.
Exactly. Well, why don't you crack up 10
sure.
eggs for us? And I'm just gonna saute some peppers and some onions just to get them a little soft. And the sausage is already cooked, so we don't need to do anything with that. So I have my pan over a medium heat. And I'm just gonna add, I don't want to overpower the onions, so maybe about a quarter cup of onions I'll add. And then maybe about a quarter cup of green bell peppers. You can use red, orange, yellow, whatever you'd like. I also love adding zucchini and whatever vegetable I have left over.
You know what's really great, Cindy? If you are on a budget, frozen vegetables.
Yes.
So what's nice, and I tell shoppers at ShopRite a lot when they're looking to shop and eat healthy on a budget, is look for those frozen produce items because they're flash frozen at the peak of their ripeness, so all the nutrients are intact. And a lot of times, if the produce item is not in season, it's going to be less expensive too.
Oh, yes.
So it's a nice healthy option.
I know. I love it when I'm in ShopRite when they have them for a dollar.
Yeah,
that's when to stock up on them.
Exactly. And it's nice because you can just use what you need for the recipe and just pop the rest in the freezer.
Exactly. You can use them whenever you want. They're always handy. So I love using the frozen vegetables too.
All right.
Great.
So we got 10 eggs here.
10 eggs. We'll whisk that up.
All right.
And I'm just going to go around you. I'm going to add a little bit of salt. My onions and peppers here. And you can add garlic if you want in here, but I'm just going to add the peppers and onions with the sausage. Like one thing I want to add in here, Lindsay,
mm-hmm.
I know we picked up some spinach.
Oh,
I'm
great.
Add a little bit of spinach in here. Wouldn't that be nice?
Yeah. And spinach is a great source of, you know, your vitamin A, your vitamin C. It's also a good source of folate and those B vitamins. So what's great, you were talking about kids. If you have your kids measuring out these ingredients and doing this and you're not sure if they'll eat vegetables, but they like cheese and eggs, it's
exactly.
a good way to introduce it into a meal they may have already, you know, enjoyed before.
Exactly. Now, because I'm Italian, I need to add some of my herbs. So I'm going to add in some parsley, about a teaspoon of each, but you can add as much as you like. If you want a little spicy, you can add some red pepper flakes.
Oh, I love that. And what's good about the dry or fresh herbs is, you know, it's adding flavor but replacing
exactly.
the salt in there. So it adds to, it makes a low sodium option.
Exactly. And then we'll just add maybe the equivalent of two sausages in here. Mm, these smell so good. These are really good at dinner last night.
You can also do chicken sausage too, make it a little bit healthier.
Exactly.
But you know, we're not using a lot, so.
That's so cool. We're gonna add them right into this egg mixture.
Looks great.
It looks great. It looks so colorful.
Yeah.
And it smells really good.
We eat with our eyes too.
We really
so
do.
So adding that pop of color really does make it a little more appetizing.
It sure does. Next, let's add in about a half a cup, if you just want to eyeball it, of
sure.
the cheddar cheese. And you could use Parmesan cheese, any kind of cheese that you like, Swiss cheese, or no cheese.
Yep.
So you can really tailor it to...
A low-sodium cheese option would be something like a Swiss cheese, which is naturally lower in sodium, if that's something you're looking for. Or you're right, it's good without it. With all the herbs you're adding, you really don't even need to add cheese.
Oh, yes. So all I'm going to do now is fill my cupcake tins. So look how cute these are going to look with the sausage and
yeah.
all the spinach and the peppers and the onions. So we're going to finish filling up each cup. They're going to go in the oven for about 25 minutes at 350. And they come out, well, we'll taste one.
Oh, sounds good.
Okay, I'm cooking here with Lindsay. Did you really make this last night and let it cook all night long and waking up in the morning to this delicious oatmeal? She made oatmeal last night.
Yes, I did. And my house smelled like apple pie in the fall and it was delicious. So it's really quick and easy. If you have a crock pot, just set it on low. You pour in the ingredients, whether it's low fat milk, almond milk,
coconut milk.
Yep. It's a good source of calcium, vitamin D, and adds a rich flavor. And instead of adding sugar, I added things like apples and raisins, some cinnamon and vanilla, and it's so sweet and delicious. It's almost like dessert, but it's a lot healthier.
Now, you could even add some pumpkin puree. Couldn't
oh, yes.
you add that in there? Because with the fall, I've been cooking so much with pumpkin, but I could even indulge with some pumpkin in there and some nutmeg. I mean, there's so many ways you can be creative in this dish. I love it, and what a way to wake up in the morning to smell this fall. You're right, it smells like an apple pie.
It does.
This is great, and we're gonna have this recipe on my website at cindystable.com along with all the substitutions and ways that you can make this delicious breakfast. So now, well, Lindsay, so far, have we had a great time or what?
Yeah.
We made the egg muffins, which taste delicious, aren't they great? And then your muffins, the banana, zucchini, oh my God.
Got your fruits and vegetables in one.
Fruits and vegetables, but let me tell you, that oatmeal, that was just so delicious, and I cannot believe that you made that last night.
It took me 2 minutes and it was ready.
Everything smells so great here. Well, do you have any other tips you want to give us about these?
So I think breakfast is a really important meal, so you don't want to skip it. And whatever your excuse is, figure out a way to work around it. I mean, we just did that right here. We prepped a lot of things ahead of time. A lot of these things we can freeze, the muffins,
exactly.
The zucchini muffins you can freeze and just defrost it the night before, and you have breakfast in the morning.
Or take it out in the morning, and by the time you get to the office, it'll be thawed
exactly.
out and ready for you to enjoy. So these are all great meals. We're gonna have all these recipes and all of the tips that you shared with us today on my blog at cindystable.com. Lindsay, what kid does not love Sloppy Joes?
I know, classic. Yeah.
Everybody loves it. And what I'm doing today is we could make this the night before or the morning, so when the kids come home from school, I know my kids would come home from school starving.
Especially if they're doing sports and they're active, they need a snack after school.
Exactly. And if you're making hamburger, you could make a bunch the night before, put some of this aside, and make this great. So I'm gonna make a great crock pot Sloppy Joes, and watch how easy this is. I already have my pan going. Now, when I was at ShopRite today,
mm-hmm.
extra lean ground beef, and I love it because there's not gonna be that much fat at the end.
Exactly.
Yeah,
it's a nice heart healthy choice, looking for that extra lean,
exactly.
Taking the time to read those labels.
Exactly. Now, at the beginning of every week, I get my vegetables. What am I making for the week? So here I go again with my peppers and my onions. They're already chopped up, so I don't have to do any more chopping. Chop once, package it up, and it's good to go. So let me start with the beef. I'm gonna come over to the stove here. I'm just going to add a little bit of olive oil,
yeah.
just so the meat doesn't stick to the bottom of the pan. Now, my pan is really hot already, so it will only take a second to warm up. Then I'm just going to add in, and that's the noise you want to hear.
And although the extra lean ground beef is great, if you wanted to make another healthy choice, you can do something like ground turkey or ground chicken, which all of your stores really have, but you know, any of those lean choices are going to be a nice, heart healthy choice.
Exactly. Now, if your kids don't like onions, we don't need to put them in there. You could add anything else, or you don't add anything at all. You could just add the ground beef.
But if you're doing something like a leaner beef or a chicken and turkey, you know, people get worried about how dry it might be. If you're adding things like the onions and peppers, it not only adds the vegetable, but it adds a nice moistness. And it also adds the flavor, too. But mushrooms would be good.
Oh, mushrooms would be fabulous.
Spinach
in there.
Would be good in that.
So you could really be creative and add whatever you want. So I'm gonna, it's the morning, I have my slow cooker on low. All I'm gonna do is add in all my ingredients. Let me just grab one of my little spatulas here. Now, it's so easy. I have ketchup. Now, this is homemade ketchup that I made, and this recipe is on my website, because I like making homemade ketchup.
Delicious.
Yes, very nice. And then I have just some flour, because it's gonna thicken it all up when it gets going. And we can mix that together. And then I have some apple cider, and this recipe will be on my website at Cindy's Table.
And what's nice about cooking everything from scratch is you know what's in there. They
exactly.
have those packets of sloppy dough, Joe mix, but how quick is this?
Well, this is quick, and you're right. I know what I'm feeding my family. Some nice chili powder to give it a little bit of
delicious.
Heat. And then I'm going to add in some Worcestershire sauce. Just a little bit, but it gives it that nice, hearty flavor.
Mm-hmm.
And just, this, you know, a few dabs will do you.
Yeah.
And then some brown sugar, and that really brings all the flavors together. And you can omit the brown sugar if you don't want to use it, but I like adding it.
And that's just a little bit.
It is just a little bit. And then I'm going to add in some water in a little bit. Then I'm going to add in a can of tomato sauce.
What's great now is in the stores, they have a lot of no salt added options for those people watching their high blood pressure. So it still makes it a nice healthy option.
Exactly. And I need about a half a cup of water, but I don't like to waste the sauce inside, so we'll just pour it right in there and give it a little swish around. And then while you're doing that, I'm going to add in just about a teaspoon of sea salt and then about a half a teaspoon of pepper.
And I'll just add this water right in
there.
For you.
Right in there. I mean, how easy was that?
It takes 2 seconds.
And just smell that. Doesn't that smell?
It's delicious.
Delicious. So we'll let our meat saute. We're going to add our meat into the slow cooker. We're going to go off to work on low for 7 hours, and when the kids come home, they're going to have a great snack.
Nice.
So when you come back, we're going to show you what the Sloppy Joe meal looks like. Lindsay, are you ready to try the Sloppy Joes?
I am.
Okay, so this has been cooking for about 7 hours on low.
And it smells
can
good.
Can you smell it? Now, you said, let's use up some of that spinach because we had some spinach from our last recipe. So you want some at the bottom?
Yeah, so you put it on the bottom and wilt with that nice hot sloppy joe.
And I think using the baby spinach really makes it.
Yeah, it's a nice light flavor.
Now, what kid won't want to come home and enjoy?
Exactly.
And you're like, we could even add zucchini in here, mushrooms, any of our favorite. And, you know, we're using whole wheat buns, but we don't have to use rolls. We can just have it over pasta, you can have it over rice, or just in a bowl. The kids can really just enjoy it. I'm gonna try some spinach as well.
Yeah, the whole wheat bun is a nice touch. It adds a good amount of fiber. It's a better choice than those white buns, so.
Exactly.
Yeah. And we made some good choices with this Sloppy Joe.
We really did make some good choices. Well, I'm gonna give it a try.
This is more of a fork and knife kind of Sloppy
Joe. It is. I guess you could pick it up, but we'll try it with the forks. But it smells. I mean, all those.
You smell the spices.
The spices, yes.
Mmm.
Mm.
That's really good.
And I can even taste that apple cider vinegar and the Worcestershire and the brown sugar. All those flavors just came together so nice. And I think any kid would want this snack before sports or an event at night. How quick it's all ready. There's, you know, nothing to microwave or go to a drive-thru. I mean, it's right at home waiting for you.
Yeah, you just need a spoon and a bun, and that's it.
Exactly. So this Sloppy Joe recipe will be on my blog and on my website at cindystable.com. Hey, welcome back to Cindy's Table. I am here with my friend Lindsay Gomes, the dietitian from the ShopRite store in both Manchester and East Hartford. And we've had a full day here. We have been cooking all day. We made breakfast, and it was delicious. Mm-hmm. We made our after-school snacks, the Sloppy Joes, which were just amazing. Every kid is going to love that. Now, I am making something that I just love, chicken pot pie.
Oh, delicious.
And what I love about this is we're going to make it in one can, but you can make it individual. And you know what I love about it? Store-bought chicken. They have the rotisserie chickens at your store. Mm-hmm. I love it. I always buy the plain one, yep. Take the skin off, chop it up, and we're going to do that last. But how easy, I don't have to cook the chicken.
Yeah.
You can cook chicken if you want. In my recipe, I will include on how to roast the chicken. But this is a great, and I'm actually making three meals with one roasted chicken. How great is that? So I'll be feeding my family for the entire week. Now, to make my chicken pot pie is so easy. I'm actually using, and this is one of your tips earlier today, frozen peas and frozen carrots.
Makes it so easy, and it's already cut into the perfect portion.
It's already cut up, and then I'm using mushrooms, and they're already sliced as well. So the only thing I have to cut up is some celery and garlic, and I cut up my onion in the beginning of the week.
Yeah, so you had over two other meals, and here's your third.
Here's my third. So I already have my cast iron pan going, and I'm gonna melt a little butter. When I make this, I like to start with butter, even though I'm sauteing the onions, but it's also going to make our roux, because we want to make it a nice thick stock. So I'm going to add...
You could probably even do a little half butter, maybe half olive oil, too.
You could, yes.
Yeah.
You can definitely do that, or if you want to use ghee or coconut oil, so depending on what you want to use. So I'm just going to get that going. Would you mind handing me one of those wooden spoons?
Sure.
You know, my Nana told me you always cook with a wooden spoon.
Yes.
So I always have wooden spoon. So I don't want the butter to get brown, I just want it melted. So then I'm gonna add a couple of tablespoons of flour. And again, you could use arrowroot if you don't want to use all-purpose flour. So what I want to create here is the roux, and that's really the thickening agent.
Yeah, it's gonna make it nice and creamy.
Nice and creamy, yes. Because you really need a creamy chicken pot pie.
Yeah, and you're adding carrots and peas, but I mean, I add mushrooms. Well, you have mushrooms in this. You could add roasted peppers to it. You can add any kind of vegetables you want. And that's another thing we were talking about, getting kids involved. You have the bowls ready of the different ingredients and have them pour it into the pot.
Right. They might want a different vegetable. You could put broccoli in there, anything. So I'm just adding a couple of cups of chicken broth now.
And we chose the low sodium today, which is good.
Exactly. This way we know how much sodium we have.
Yeah, we can control it.
Exactly, exactly. So I'm just gonna let this, I'm gonna add a couple of cups. And I'm just gonna let it simmer here. Keep an eye on it and let it just go. Now I have my onions, so I'm gonna add my onions in here now too.
What are we gonna do? Let everything just kind of marry and melt together?
Melt together, it's gonna be great. And then I have a garlic clove. And I was just thinking, Thanksgiving's coming. We could do this with turkey.
You could do that. So your leftover turkey, you have a big meal, you end up buying too much turkey.
How great is this?
For such a little party, and then you have the leftovers. It's a great way to
use
it.
How great is this? So I'm just gonna cut up. This is a pretty big garlic clove, so I think I'll just use one. You know, your kids might not want too much garlic. Yeah. If I'm making this for my husband and I'd probably add a couple of cloves of garlic because we like the garlic taste.
And we're putting them in one dish today, right?
Exactly. Everything's in one dish.
And what's nice is when the kids make it, if you have the individual dishes, they can make their own. They can put different ingredients in the ones that they want.
Exactly. And then they think it's theirs.
Yeah.
I made this. They're proud of it. It's theirs.
And then they're more likely to try it.
Exactly. So I'm just going to chop up a couple of celery stalks. I'm going to add that right in here. This is so easy and it's so delicious. Okay, I'm going to add this in here as well.
It's a great way to use that rotisserie chicken.
Oh, absolutely.
Like I said, if you cook a big chicken the beginning of the week, think about what you're going to use it for. You have the chicken pot pie. You could do roasted chicken on a salad or a healthy fajita with roasted vegetables.
Absolutely.
There's so many things you can use it for.
There's so many great ways to
and
use it.
And make it easy on yourself.
Exactly.
That's how you cook all the time.
Oh, I do. And I noticed when I was at ShopRite, you had the whole chickens on sale.
Yes.
They were like 79 cents a pound.
Our crazy chicken week.
I bought two. I made two. We had a roasted chicken for dinner, and then I made chicken salad, chicken pot pie. I made, my blue cheese chicken frittata. Amazing. So there were so many great ways that we used it,
Might as well. You have the oven on once.
Right.
Might as well cook two different
meals. I'm not doing any extra work. So I'm just going to chop up. These are already sliced. I could add them in there, but I just want them a little smaller. Just maybe a half a cup.
Make everything a little more consistent.
Exactly. This way, because I can take a nice bite at a time without cutting anything. So that's going to be perfect. So we're going to add this into our pot as well.
Looks good already.
Doesn't it look really nice?
Got a nice variety of vegetables in there.
Exactly. It's going to be nice and hearty,
yes,
too. I mean, we love the comfort food now.
Yeah. Add a nice salad on the side. You got a complete meal.
Oh, yes. Oh, yeah. You know what I saw the other day?
Mm-hmm.
Baby kale in a package.
Oh, yeah.
Instead of the, you know, a big piece of kale, and it was already sliced up and ready to go for a salad.
Yeah. That would be delicious. Maybe throw a little bit of cranberry since it's the season, some walnuts, a little light dressing with the apple
cider. Butternut squash in there.
That would be delicious.
Amazing. So we're going to add
for another segment.
I know. Once we get on a roll of food. So I'm going to add, because I'm Italian, you know me by now, Lindsay.
Yes.
I need to add in my Italian herbs. I'm a typical Italian.
What do you have, oregano?
I'm going to have oregano, basil, parsley. If I want to spice it up, I can add some red pepper flakes.
Oh, nice.
But I won't tonight.
What's great about all those herbs is, you know, you're not adding salt to the dish. We've picked a low sodium option for the broth. We're adding herbs. They add such great flavor, especially
exactly.
when you have them dried, if it's not the summertime. Or, you know, you can always freeze your herbs in the summer
exactly.
and just pull those out and put it in the dish.
I mean, come over and smell this.
Oh.
That's just
delicious.
Amazing. Okay, so now I can add in my peas and my corn. I mean, it's already,
mm-hmm.
peas and my carrots are already.
Look how easy
this.
See,
I mean,
cooking can be easy and delicious.
Yes, and not expensive. A
exactly.
lot of people email me and say, I can't afford to be healthy. Well, you can. If you take our shopping tips
mm-hmm.
and shop right and make a list before you go and plan your meals, it can be very affordable.
Yeah. Look at the circular first. You see that rotisserie chicken's on sale? Maybe that's the week you
exactly.
do all your chicken dishes.
Exactly. So what I did, I already peeled the chicken
mm-hmm.
apart because we already had some for dinner.
Yeah, we want to take the skins off of the chicken.
We took the skins off. We have the breast here. Yeah, I can take this one piece of skin and take off here. And then this is this is the entire rest of the chicken. So there's no need to waste any of this. And I'm just going to chop it up. I mean, this is going to be...
so good.
So good. And look at the mess I'm making. I'm not making a mess.
Yeah.
I mean, I just love, just put this right in here, that this is so easy.
Yeah, great for entertaining, especially when you do those individual servings.
Individual ones. Or if you want to do a family style,
mm-hmm.
we can make it in the 9x9
yeah.
or 9x10 baking dish, and everybody can take a scoop.
And a lot
so
of this
nice.
Stuff you prep and do ahead of time, so it's just popping it in the oven when
right.
your guests are over for dinner.
Right, and I'm not, like I said, I use rotisserie chicken,
mm-hmm.
so I let the store do all the work for me.
Mm-hmm.
Now my chicken is cut up, and add it right to
ready
our
to go.
This is...
You can even make this a vegetarian option, too.
Oh,
do
absolutely.
All the vegetables, maybe even add some beans instead of the meat in there to add some protein.
Absolutely. And another way that I love to make this, we're going to use the puff pastry crust,
mm-hmm.
but you could use leftover mashed potatoes.
Oh, that would be good.
Or
sweet potatoes. Or you could do a cauliflower and mashed potato mix, a little
exactly.
bit lower in
so,
the carbohydrates.
Exactly.
But what's nice about the puff pastry is traditional pot pie has the crust on the bottom and the top. So we're cutting a lot of calories and
we
fat
are.
By just having the top puff pastry.
Exactly.
I like that.
Now I'm going to add just a little bit of half and half because... I want it to be really creamy.
Mm-hmm.
So even though it's nice and creamy now, just about a cup.
Okay.
And we're gonna let that simmer. And while that's simmering, why don't we get our pan ready
sure.
for our crust. What a day. It's been so great having you here in my kitchen. Did you have a good time today?
I had a great time.
Well, we're ending it with this chicken pot pie. I mean, look at this, the
looks
colors.
Delicious.
Doesn't it smell amazing? So I added some olive oil in my baking
mm-hmm.
dish just to prevent it from sticking, but it shouldn't stick. And look at this, I just wanna...
Oh, look at all those vegetables.
Oh my gosh.
Fresh herbs, oh, it's delicious.
So good, the mushrooms, the onions, the peppers. I think I could just, let's see if I can. I look cool. Oh, I can, look at this. I can do it, because I'm strong. I do CrossFit.
And you eat your fruits and vegetables.
I eat my fruits and vegetables, exactly. So, here we go. Oops, I need this. I'm just gonna give it a little shake.
Oh, so we need a little egg right
here. We need a little egg.
Top.
And I'm just going to spread this around. Oh my gosh, it smells so good.
It really didn't take that long either.
No, and I am using the puff pastry, which is very traditional, but again, we talked
mm-hmm.
about adding mashed potatoes, sweet potatoes,
yeah.
cauliflower, whatever you want. Now watch. Look at this. Is that too easy or what? Now, I'm going to use that fork if you don't mind.
Oh, yeah, go right ahead.
I just want to create, just a, you know, I want to bring it around. Actually, I think I'll use a knife here. Oh, I have a perfect knife here. I just want to cut it. But I do want some to hang over because the egg wash will stick to it.
Yeah, seal everything in there.
And it looks really nice.
Yeah.
And I think people like to pick at it on the side.
You know, the crust is
the crust.
Part.
Everybody loves the crust. So I'm just going to pick that. Go around here.
But it's definitely a healthier version than your mom's chicken pot pie.
It sure is.
You know, we're cutting back on the crust that we're using. We're adding, you know, the lean chicken breast from the rotisserie chicken.
Absolutely.
We're adding, you know, all those great vegetables. And like they said, you can make it a vegetarian option.
Exactly.
You can omit the crust altogether and put those healthy root vegetables.
Exactly.
You can, butternut squash would be good on top.
Oh, I've done that before. It's so,
yeah.
So yummy. So I'm just going to brush the egg wash just so it sticks to it. You want to stick to it nice. So we'll finish doing the egg wash. We're going to put it in the oven for about 30, 35 minutes. Thanks again for being with us today, and we hope all of our tips and recipes are really helpful to you.
And stop by and see me at ShopRite of East Hartford or Manchester. All my services are free to customers. So if you want some more healthy eating tips, come by and see me.
Bye.
Bye.